Welcome back to my channel, Aparna's Home TV, your one-stop destination to your everyday life. In today's video, I got you a yummy Batura recipe that is everyone's favorite. Instead of eating outside, try it once at home. I'm pretty sure that you will stop eating outside. It is the same delicious recipe that is made outside. You will now absolutely love it. Your family will absolutely love it. You can serve this batura with chole, butter chicken, butter paneer, shahi paneer, paneer matar, or simple potato tomato curry. It will taste absolutely delicious. Do try it for a change, for breakfast or dinner, and your family will love you for it. So let's go and see how to make this delicious batura. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. Let's look at the ingredients we need to make batura. First is ghee or butter, 1 tablespoon, yogurt, 1/2 cup, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of sugar, a bowl to mix everything in, 1 teaspoon of semolina or rava, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, and 2 1/2 cups of maida. So let's add in all these ingredients and let's mix our batter. Important thing you need to remember when you are making batura is it needs to ferment for at least 4 to 5 hours. So always remember that you need to soak in the batter minimum of 4 hours. So plan accordingly and enjoy this delicious batter. So I'm taking 2 1/2 cups of flour, 1 teaspoon of semolina, 1 teaspoon of sugar, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of salt. Mix them all together nicely. We added all our dry ingredients and we forgot 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. That is very, very important. So here goes in our 1/2 teaspoon. Mix everything in and now goes in our butter or ghee. Just add in 1 tablespoon and that is enough. Blend it all in. And now we are going to add our yogurt. I have 1/2 cup of yogurt here. I'm adding everything in here. It needs to soak in, guys. Always remember that. Now we'll use water to make the dough. I will use the water, make the dough and then show you. Our dough is ready. You knead it for a couple of minutes, minimum of 5 minutes, so that it becomes nice and soft. It took little more than 1/2 cup of water. Adjust according to your dough. Do not add all the water at once. You don't want a sticky dough. You just want a soft dough. Just like puris, we are going to make the dough same like that. So it's been 5 minutes. So we'll rest this for four to five hours and then I'll show you how to make the dough batura. So it's been 5 hours since we mixed the dough. Look how puffed up it is and soft and ready for us to make our baturas. I have my, we call it like chata,
I don't know what they call it in English, but somewhere you can arrange your bataras and it will be ready for you when you want to fry it. I'm not going to make big batura. I'll show you how much size I'm going to make. So let's make the balls first, dough balls, then we'll make our baturas. I'm going to make really, really small baturas, so I'm only taking this much. Little bit smaller. This will make around 12 to 16, I believe. So be careful about the size you want. You might want smaller ones, you can make smaller ones. If you are into bigger ones, you can make bigger ones. Let me do all the things and then I'll show you how to make the batura. I'm making 15 baturas from this batter, so let's make them. Take a small ball, roll it nicely, dip it in the powder dough, and we are going to roll it oval shaped. It's nice and soft, guys. Your baturas will be like so good, you won't believe it. They will be so good. It should be neither too thick nor too thin. If it's too thick, then your puri batura won't cook nicely. Even though it's brown from the outside, it will be uncooked from the inside. So you don't want like high heat and very fastly done batura. Almost ready. This is maida, so it will come together. Even though you roll it too thin, it will come together, guys. So this is how I like to make my baturas. Let me make all my baturas, then I'll show you how to fry them. Oil is heating up for batura. I kept it on medium heat. I'm going to serve my batura with yummy and delicious butter chicken. Recipe is already in my YouTube channel if you want to make it. You can serve it with chana, chole, rajma, aloo masala. You can serve it with anything. It will taste absolutely great. So let's make this yummy batura. Oil is hot, as you can see. Let's slowly drop our batura. Press it ever so lightly. Whoa, look at that. Look how perfectly it came. Flip it. Little bit, wait little bit more before flipping it. Let it fry nicely. And of course, you have to flip it. Look at that, guys. That's how a batura should be. Almost ready. Flip it once more. Look at that color, guys. I hope you'll try this recipe and leave your feedback for me. I will see you guys in my next video. Thank you so much for watching me, guys. Absolutely delicious. Do try it. It will be just like your restaurant style.